Welcome back to Golf Simulator Videos. Today we're going to show you how to calibrate your UNEEKOR EYE XO golf launch monitor or golf simulator. Okay, I had someone reach out during a live stream and say, hey, would you do a how to calibrate video? And I thought that's a great idea. I mean, in my full installation and setup video of QED, which is their unit that's actually located 3.5 feet behind the ball, and then now you have this unit 3.5 feet in front of the ball, I did do a full setup and I kind of did some, you know, speed ramping through there just because it was a long video showing you like a complete installation. And the EYE XO, I kind of did a little more of an abbreviated video and I did not show you how to calibrate your EYE XO, but I also wanted to show you guys some troubleshooting tips. Okay, so I actually helped someone Saturday night get around some problems they were having. It was actually a unit that my partner and I helped get this gentleman into, and he wanted to get up and running and I helped him out. And you know, on that subject, if you are looking for a QED or an EYE XO, make sure you reach out to me. My partner and I we've just been helping a ton of people. And what's awesome is that my partner has full wholesale access to all of the other necessary items like turf and screen and projectors and computers and you name it. He can do like an all-in-one simulator that just shows up and you're ready to get going. So that it's really, really cool. So make sure you reach out to me. But you know, support's obviously an important thing, and we always try to help with that even outside of normal business hours. So we got him up and running. It was actually an antivirus program that it was previously installed on his computer that was causing issues, and I'm going to show you some of those troubleshooting tips today. All right, so I have my board here. That's your calibration board that comes with the unit. All right, we're going to use that. Now, there is a level that comes with this. It's a little circular, level that you set down. It has a little eye on the top. I like using this nice, heavy level that I have, metal level. And I'll show you just kind of, it just makes it a little bit easier because you can set it right on top and push down, all right, in all directions. It can even lay like this, all right, and it works like the circle level does. So this has just become a very useful tool to me for calibrating. So if you have one of those or you'd like to purchase one, I would highly recommend it, all right? It has just about every type of level you could think of inside of their dual levels, and it's nice and heavy. It's a great tip, okay? But don't get me wrong, you can use that circle level. You just have to be a little more precise and get that in all corners in the center, all right, and make sure the entire board is level. The other thing is you want the board square to your target, all right? I've seen some people laying them down and it's not square to their target. That's going to cause balls to not be directly on line. So make sure they're, I'm lucky, I have these lines going right to my target and screen, so I can set that down. It's pretty easy to tell it's square to my target. So if you don't, make sure that you could either, you know, measure whatever you need to do, make sure it's square. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, the first thing you're going to want to do is jump into your File Explorer, go to your C drive. All right, once you have all those files installed, you should have an EYE XO sensor folder. All right, now this EYE XO tool is what we're going to be using today. If that is not there, you have problems. All right, and what you're going to first want to do is I always tell everybody, if you're new to Windows, just go into Programs. It says Add or Remove Programs. I'm searching down in the lower left there. And if you look in this list and you have any type of common antivirus, you know, his was McAfee, but I know there's a lot of other, you know, antivirus programs out there, and it's in there. You can actually sort by install date if you need to. Maybe it came with the computer and you can go down there, but simply uninstall that. You just click on it, click uninstall, and get that antivirus off your computer. It's going to cause issues. I can promise you that. That's what happened to him. All right. Now, next, if that file's missing, we're going to want to go down, and this is something you may just want to do anyway. All right. But we're going to want to go to settings. All right. Just type in settings. All right. It's going to bring us here. And then you're going to go down to update and security. All right. And that's going to bring you to this page where you can go to Windows security. All right. And then once you're in Windows security, there's a virus and threat protection, all right, that you can open up. All right. Now, you can probably search and get right there, but I know that the search function sometimes for people can get them in the wrong area. So I figured I would just kind of do a step by step from the settings page. All right. Now, after your install, if you go to this protection history location and you see that EYE XO tool or other files here, you can go ahead and approve those. All right. So that's where it's going to dump them. Now you can see my firewall is off. That's another little trick. I don't mind running with my firewall off. All right, it's not going to block anything because it's actually turned off. I'm not going to recommend that to you guys because if you're a general user and you don't know how to protect yourself, you may want to leave that on. Okay, but yes, Windows Firewall and Defender does cause, you know, quite a bit of issues. All right, and if you feel comfortable turning it off, go ahead. That's your choice. I just don't want to make a recommendation that could make you vulnerable to something. But yeah, I run mine off. I don't do any web browsing or downloading of things that would cause me risk. So I feel comfortable having it off. And you can simply just search for your firewall and then just turn it off. Virus and threat protection. All right, if you've approved those files, what you're going to want to do now is you're going to want to go to manage settings. All right. And then down here, it says add or remove exclusions. All right. And that is where you can go in and you can add these exclusions. All right. Right here, it says add exclusion. You can find these folders and files. All right. The IXO tool and then add them. All right, see how I've added all those? I have my IXO, I actually have my Zcam sensor for QED. All right, those are all in this. See, I added the whole QED folders in there. All right, you can add all of these, and then you know that they're gonna get passed through. Now, if for some reason at this stage, you open up your IXO tool, all right, and you don't have all your green lights, which we can do right now, I actually did a reinstall for him, and it actually solved the problem. All right, one of the files must have got completely blocked and not quarantined like that. We did a reinstall at this point after we had everything approved and I had that antivirus off there and we were good to go. We had all the green lights and everything worked fine. Okay, so let's get into the calibration side of things. So you're gonna open up your IXO tool and I'm gonna go ahead and just move this over a little bit because of my camera. All right. And the first thing you're going to want to do is grab your calibration board. And I'm going to show you something on it really quick. That's a little circle. See if we can get that to go ahead and focus in. All right. And that little circle down here, all right, right here, that actually needs to be towards the back. And it's going to go right at the crosshairs, the red crosshairs you see on the right side. We're going to use the side cam for this. All right. Now, understand something. This may be farther forward than you plan on hitting. I'm going to show you how to move that, and mine may look different than yours because I've already moved my, see where it says area setting? You can move your area setting. So sometimes if you're having a difficult time seeing the circle, you can even set something right where the circle is, and now it's really easy to see it, and you can move it there. If you can't see your board at all, see this button right here that says brightness? This allows you to actually increase the brightness of the camera. Okay, no reason to overexpose. Whatever works for you and you can see properly should be just fine. So now that I know that I have that circle perfectly in the crosshairs and it looks like I am perfectly square to my target, all right, I'm going to set my level down on the board. And I can already see that I'm going to need to push down a little bit on this side. Now I have my soft strike mat, which I know many of you have seen. It makes it really easy to just push down and get this board level. Now let's say you're using like a heavy duty mat of some sort. It's going to be a little harder to push down probably, huh? Well, you could just simply use maybe shims or something underneath your actual hitting mat and you could be able to get that nice and level that way. So I got it level left and right, and then I'm going to look this way. Look at that, perfectly level. All right, and then I could even go on an angle. All right, it looks perfect. So my board is perfectly level. All right, I want to make sure it's square to my target, which it is. Now notice how the board doesn't look square up there. Well, don't pay attention to that. It's on the crosshairs where it's supposed to be, and it's square to my target line. Okay, that's what I want. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit calibration. And it's going to start recognizing. Look at that. That was quick. Calibration success. All right. Now let's say that green area, all right, that is going to be your hitting area. Now let's go to area setting really quick. Now this is where, and we can increase that brightness a little bit so we could actually see our hitting area a little better. This is where you can actually move your hitting area. And it's quite large. Look how far you can move this around. All right, now I like mine right about, I like it right in the center of my mat, and I like it just a little back right about here. All right, And I can look at my board that's still on the ground right now and say, you know, I'm never going to put a ball past that third, like halfway through that third square. It really would never be there. And so now I know, and I could even almost go three back because I don't hit that far forward. So I might even bring mine back just a little bit further. All right, now it looks like I'm good to go. And then I can just hit confirm. Okay, now see how I'm on one area mode? I know a lot of people, you can use two areas. I recommend one area. What it allows you to do is it allows you to set different boxes for both just a normal shot, for your tee, and for your putting. Okay, you can have things off to the side and do that. If that's something you need, it's really not that hard to use, and I used it in the past. I actually had my tee box area right over here, okay, to the right of my board. And then I had my hitting area. I just find it easier to have one nice big hitting area and not have to, you know, deal with the different, set areas. So now that I know it's in the area that I want, and it looks like it's covering that whole hitting zone, I'm going to hit confirm. All right. And you can see how that box moved a little bit. And then if you just wanted to kind of, you know, double check, like, all right, so where is my ball going to be when I hit all the time? It's going to be right here. And now you can see I'm well within my hitting area. Okay. And I could even have moved it further back if I wanted to, but it kind of gives me, I'm never going to hit back here. I mean, that's really far back. But it gives me that. And I'll tell you what, all the way up forward. Yeah. So, I mean, that's just where mine's going to be. It's nice and dead center. Okay. And then once I'm done with that, I could even move mine back just a hair more, but I'm going to leave it right there. I kind of like where it is. And I'm going to hit confirm. Okay. Now I am done. Let's go ahead and just launch view really quick. And I'm doing a screen capture today, so it's a little different than normal. You guys are kind of seeing my desktop, which I think just makes it easier to do something like this. I really encourage you guys to email me if you have questions. I mean, I enjoy helping people. I mean, if you bought a unit from a different dealer, I'm probably going to direct you to them if it's a support type issue, because I don't want to get in the middle of, your dealer support, and yourself, I guess, if you want to say that. I was trying to find what I was, looking for there. But, if you purchase it through myself and my partner, I mean, I'm there like I was on Saturday night to help. So let's go ahead and just hit a ball and we're good to go. Now, if you wanted to maybe be a little more precise and see how straight everything is, we could even do this. All right, we know it's working inside of view. I can close this out and I can launch succeed. All right. Now, some of you may not have purchased succeed with your package, I should say. Some of you have. I actually really enjoy the software. It's pretty cool. You know, it's their own simulation software versus others. And you can see how this thing is adjusting right now, because probably because I'm recording the screen. There it goes. We're all good. And then it looks like I need to make it fit the screen, which we can. There we go. Not gonna lie, I was nervous for a second there. Almost 15 minutes into the video, and if my recording software would have messed that up. So if you have a 4K monitor like I do, you have to force it to run in 1080p. That's something I actually found out and I shared with the UNEEKOR support team. So they should know about it if you're talking to them. But if for some reason you don't, you could let me know. So short game complex. All right, let's go to putting. All right, and let's just go to practice mode. And distance, we're gonna leave at yards, that's fine. Right-handed, time, I usually actually just crank the time all to infinity, but let's load this up. I feel like putting is one of those, you know, precise type things that you're always gonna wanna make sure is right. And I was actually using Succeed the other day and I hadn't put on it for a little while, and it's funny how the different software is always just a little bit different with putting. So you kind of almost need to practice each software, whatever you're going to play, a little bit, which is good. You know, kind of gives you variation, if you want to call it that. Gives you some different things to work on. Okay, so there's an 18-foot putt. Let's just go to a 15-foot putt. All right. And you can actually do free set if you want to. See how it's on a big, you can go to free set, okay? And then you can change the pin location if you want to, wherever you want. And then you can even just change your ball location. Like, let's say we just wanted to make it nice and level. Let's see how that is. There we go. Nice short putt, you know, with just a little bit of right break, and it's 10 feet long, a little bit downhill. So this will be perfect for being able to test. Now, the other thing you guys always want to make sure is you want to make sure your lights are locked on. So if I move these right now, they're going to start blinking. Okay. I know it's active if they're blinking like that. And then when I set my ball down, it locks on. I don't use the noise because I don't find it necessary. I mean, it picks up the ball really, really fast. And then let's see if we can just putt this. I'm going to aim just a little bit left. You can aim right inside the simulator, which is really nice. That's the nice part about having an overhead camera system like that. All right. I'd say that it's on, wouldn't you? You can see the video replay. And this is a kind of a hidden feature, you know, while we're at it. You can practice your putting inside of the simulation software. Okay, succeed, or look at this. And I can slow it down if I want to. Succeed or refine is what I was looking for there. Now, it does use your photo and illustration on full clubs as well. Don't get me wrong. But, you know, if you want to replay that putter path and face, you can see I kept my face very square. Okay, and that ball rolled right down the line. Now, this is another clear identifier that we have the unit calibrated properly, okay? The ball, okay, I had that face just a tiny bit to the left because of that break, and the ball is just a tiny bit left of the line, and you could see that, how it started, and then used the break and went right inside the hole. But the other identifier is that line, that putting line, is dead square with my mat. So I know that that line is perfect. Okay, I know that I got a good calibration. I can be happy with that, that if I'm putting dead down that line and I'm square with my mat right here, okay, I'm good to go. So I really hope that this included some good troubleshooting tips and how to calibrate your UNEEKOR EYE XO. I'm always here to try to help you guys as much as I can. Don't get me wrong, I get tons of emails and I try to answer them as fast as I can. You know, if you're using myself and my partner to purchase a UNEEKOR product, understand that you're going to get first priority. We're always going to help you try to resolve any issues. So I always encourage you reaching out to me if you're looking to purchase a product. We offer, you know, the best of the best support, you know, for that. So I only pick partners that I know can deliver that customer satisfaction, you know, and they're busy. They can't be available 24/7. And so that's why I'm there for the backup and I enjoy helping, you know. And so if you guys are looking for anything like that, make sure you let me know. If you have any questions, make sure you comment below in the video. Feel free to ask those questions, comments, anything you have. I hope this was a really useful video for everybody that may be setting up their UNEEKOR EYE XO for the first time. And I'll let you get through that on a Sunday night or something if it showed up and you're going to try to knock that yourself. I mean, it's really a do-it-yourself system, I'll be honest. I've installed QED and EYE XO on my own with no issues whatsoever. And I know a lot of other people that have, you know. And if you need help, hey, that's all right too. So make sure you check out all the videos on the channel because I probably have answered quite a bit of the questions that you may have. But as always, I appreciate you guys watching and we'll talk to you soon.